the summer club.
Thank you very much.
I'm now selecting the American minister.
Oh yeah, we were just visiting. We had a good good visit.
Well, sit down. Take it off or hide it there. That's it.
In Berlin und die zum Ausdruck bringen, dass die Berliner sich sehr wohl darüber im Klaren sind, dass ihre Freiheit abhängig ist von dem Engagement der Vereinigten Staaten.
President, I would like to thank you also on behalf of the Berliners for the strong commitment you have ever shown to Berlin, and we are well aware that we are dependent on the protection of the United States.
Ich freue mich, dass im nächsten Monat Clark an der Spitze einer Delegation zum Jahrestag der Blockade nach Berlin kommen wird. Das ist ein sehr wichtiges Ereignis, in dem auch symbolisiert wird die Entwicklung der Freundschaft zwischen den Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika und Berlin. Und ich habe Ihnen zur Erinnerung daran ein Geschenk mitgebracht.
This is to come up with the Mr. President. Oh. Thanking you for sending Judge Clark to Berlin for the anniversary.
Das ist ein Teller, ein bisher ein Unikat, das ist also ein Siebenbomber.
The first plate of the series that is going to be issued, showing one of the raisin bombers, as we call them.
Candy bombers. And that's the sign of this ceremony we have in May in Berlin.
Thank you very much. Well, I'm very pleased to have that.
Okay.
Well, I am very pleased, and we are determined to assure the. Yes, I.
It's been interesting.
China. I'm still waiting for someone to tell me what to do about sea slugs.
The best thing is don't think about it.
Thank you, gentlemen.
All right.
Thank you as well.
Yes. Isn't that true?
And I want you to meet one of the best House members. You know him well.
I know him. Well, how are you?
Barry stood us up today.
Oh, yes, shame on him.
See that.
This is the author of the resolutions, President.
No,
good.
You know,
it's
good.
Nice to do this.
Yes, very much so. Right. We do appreciate it.
Sydney Schreer, the Parkinson Foundation. It's my pleasure.
Come behind me.
Listen, why don't you
stay a little of your major kind of
roundups? Yes.
Sure.
Mr. President, let me get the photographers in.
Mm-hmm.
Photographers.
It's a little easier than some of your duties today, huh, Mr. President?
Well, this is a pleasure to sign with. And I think all of us hope and pray that the organization will come forth with a cure for this.
We will find it.
Has victimized 1.5 million of our citizens. Right. Gee, I'm going to get to write my whole name with one pen.
One of the rare changes.
Cost me several votes.
Oh, so. That's the least you can do. That's right.
There.
Thank you very much.
You're not going to ask him for a commitment, are we, Mr. President?
No.
Just the fighting it. Good to see you. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank all of you.
Thank you again.
That's good.
see you.
This is Mrs. Manuel, Mr. Manuel. They're from my home.
And I thought you might like these old postcards that you want to hang of Dixon, Illinois. Well, that's a small
town. Mr. President, you went to the Highway Department, and they met postal cards exchange.
French cards didn't make it in America.
Well, that's the new bridge and the new fence.
You didn't get it.
That's the Massachusetts Tavern. There, right
oh, that's not the same high school.
That I went to. I went to. Now it's a separate high school. It's on one side and it's outside. Now this is the high school. There's the bridge that I crossed when I was 18, but it was only a wind chill, so I don't know how to go over here.
Oh, there's a word.
But I want this here. This,
I don't know, this governor. Let me see what he says there.
The old law cabin. Yes, this is out at a place called Hazelwood.
Yeah.
And that once belonged to a family of James Russell Lowell, the poet.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it was at that place, looking up the river, that he wrote to a waterfowl.
Yeah.
The poem.
Yeah. I go back to high school. English, remember that?
Yeah, the Dixon State Hospital. That's closed down at Mental Hospital. Well, this is.
This is some newer cards that a artist put out.
The church, yes. Uh-huh. And that's the
I haven't located a real picture card.
Is this your home, Mr. Brent?
Huh?
Yeah.
That's it. That's the one they've restored. Yeah. And that's the dam behind. This is the power plant. And that's the river where he's lifeguarded for 7 years.
And we just fixed them where you can see both sides and have the dates that they were mailed and who they were mailed to. And.
Oh, I want to give you a new card for the first week of next month. It'll be the first time it's ever been celebrated. And we're going to work this in conjunction with the first National Postcard Week.
Well, thank you very much.
Our friend down in Manassas, we're staying with them, and he wanted me to have that.
Well, thank you very much.
It was great seeing you.
Yeah. How are you? How are you, sir? Good. Nice to see you.
Chairman of the board, so to speak. I like to see who wants to make a presentation.
I know the Reagan brothers done for us. And,
come on over.
The Woodgrovers have done for us, too. And
come on over.
Well, thank you. We'd like to make this presentation on behalf of the National Wool Growers, a bolt of wool cloth grown in America, fabricated in America for you and Mrs. Reagan.
Well, thank you very much.
Appreciate a red sheet. That came out of the dye. It just happened that it's your color, Mrs. Reagan's color.
Yes.
And we're just happy for everything you've done for us in the industry. Appreciate it very much.
Thank you very much. Well, this is wonderful. Thank you.
Is Nancy still wearing her Reagan red?
Oh, yes. She'll buy anything that's red. Well, she'll be very pleased to have this. I am pleased also. Thank you.
Mr. President, these are people who really believe in you and have for many, many years. And you know we're all behind you, every one of us in this room right now. Thank you for the time today, Mr. President.
Great pleasure.
Very, very generous of you to let us be. We'll support you as we can.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Give us a word of order. We appreciate it. All right. This, I think, we... That is the clerk, sir. Plaster and bronze.
Yes.
You have to drop blood, drop the blood.
It's a great pleasure.
Mr. President?
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember Agnes Jarman?
I sure do. Hello. Yes. Hello, sir.
Nice to see you.
My grandson, Michael.
Please meet you.
Well, it's good to see you again.
Well, it's wonderful to see you.
Bill's making it possible.
So do I.
Well, you remember we had a nice visit last time. There were some wonderful photographs in the lab. She's finally completed her gift to you.
I hate to hear.
We promise there's
somebody slipped up. I was looking to see who was holding them.
They're a bit heavy.
I see. Here they go.
We brought two pets. Oh, there's the pet.
Two ladies.
There you
go. Lift it off. This is the first one. And they sent me photographs. You ought to have a pedestal for this. It's a common thing.
If they tell me where it is, I'll get it.
It was in the other room.
Miss, can you tell me where the other pedestal is? Well, thank you. They are wonderful. I appreciate it.
I can't tell you how it worked on them.
My briefing said one was plastic and one was bronze.
No, they're both bronze. Both bronze. And I like the bases. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And when Catherine at home said, I don't think Preston Brayton left that brochure. Anyway, God. I said, well, I can't change it now. Okay.
It's just fine. Just fine. Switch it. It's fine.
We're having a busy day. Mrs. Reagan was up on the hill receiving a little gift.
Oh.
Congressional wise.
This young man is great.
Well,
Mrs. LePage on the way down.
Can I get around here?
That's in my lifetime, as I know, by far, the finest president.
Thank you, sir, very much.
I voted for you today.
I voted for you, Doug. In the same election?
Yeah. You know what I think the Salvation is kind of
looking at.
You can't take any more of this.
Hello, Mr. Brown. Hi, how are you? Is it Mr. Miss Danforth, Mr. President?
Well, hello there. I know we've been having trouble getting together here. We finally were able to
make it. He wanted to present your painting. It took him about 2 months to paint. He's a very gifted artist. Come on up with him. You come on in.
Mr. President, I've been an admirer of you for some number of years and of late your administration and policies. Especially, I appreciate personally your leadership in the country, and would like to present this to you. It's a small appreciation, a token of my appreciation, and I hope that this will serve to show the beauty of our state, South Carolina.
Well, it certainly does, and it's
not small, it's beautiful.
That's Pawleys Island.
That's right. It's
Georgetown.
What's your name?
It is, look. Well, that's beautiful. Wow. That is beautiful.
Thank you. And I appreciate the Senator for assisting me in being able to make this presentation to you. And anyone, I'm sure he can attest to the fact that South Carolina has some beautiful scenes, and this is one that I made especially for this occasion.
It's just beautiful. Brent, thank you very much.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
This is very generous and kind of you.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you.
It's a real honor.
Thank you, sir.
Very kind of you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Nancy, how are you?
Oh, nice to see you. This is Beverly Hoff, the daughter, Laura.
Hello there.
And Gary Hoff,
Mr.
President.
How do you do?
Fine, thank you, sir.
Well, you know something? There's a fellow named Gary. Got the same name.
That's right. I feel pretty honored to be here, sir.
Well, listen, I am so pleased with this. I know that very well.
And you know he's in Kansas? He's in Kansas.
Burt's Kansas.
Well, I didn't know
yeah.
that.
Yes, and that's why this is kind of special.
Everything about this is Kansas. He was first born there. And 1979 is my community. And I saved the number one princess back in 1979 for this occasion.
Mrs. Stone.
Guessed, huh?
You bet I guessed.
Mrs. Stone told us that you were very good friends.
Yes.
And she would like for you to have one, so we've been holding on to it.
Yeah.
This is a great place.
He was
everybody's dog. He was everybody's dog. Oh, I tell you, this is, no, the wood's oak from Kansas, and everything about it. There's an old mill in Iowa over 100 years old, and that was made my old mill. Still working today.
Well, I think
but I'll tell you one thing, this is one of the greatest pleasures I've ever had.
Well, I should tell you, I am a fan of Western art.
We're very proud of Gary Hawk in Kansas, Mr. President. He's done some wonderful Western art and Midwestern art as well.
My good friend Rex Allen is one of those two.
Oh. As you can see looking around.
I noticed.
Well, if you ever get to Iola, Kansas, you be sure and come by. Yeah.
You know, Iola's a town you leave home, it's time to be there and still not be late.
Thank you very much.
God bless you.
Thank you very much. You're very generous.
Well, appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you, Nancy.
Goodbye.